Here at LGS, training for the Rio 2016 Olympics has begun. Let's take a sneaky peek.
You can't touch this. Can't touch this.
This is an important announcement from the Department of Education. Today we have a representative from Safe Drivers NI. Today she's here to give us some tips on good driving, the do's and don'ts of the road.
Rule number one, always remember to only take up one car parking space. Number two, always be cautious of curbs. Number three, always be aware and respectful of pedestrians. Rule number four, always keep your music at an acceptable level. And I look forward to seeing all you safe drivers out in the road.
Well, hello everyone. Today, me and my partner Lucas are going to be introducing quite a new piece of fashion, the Vogue robe. Here we are, there's our model.
Just look at it.
Just fabulous, complements the figure beautifully. You know what I love about this piece, Lucas? I don't know if you agree, but it's just, it sits all weather, you know, you have it in the fall, the spring. The shoes go so well. The shoes, just love it. Just that little bit of heel, you know, just lifts it up off the ground a bit.
Vogue robe, it's a reasonable price. Reserve yours online today.
So dirty, even Gus is trying to go with it.
Chef Ramsay, how are the contestants in this year's show?
Yeah, they've been really good up to a certain point, although a few of them don't know how to cook.
Really? Like who?
Well, one chap put a banana in a microwave, we all know how that went.
Seriously?
Yep. Another individual, for some reason, decided to redecorate my restaurant.
What happened?
They thought it'd be funny to put Burger King's logos on the wall.
Burger King? Who goes to Burger King?
Rebecca, gonna have to ask for your jacket.
Nope.
Mike! No, 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 no.
Come
to me!
No! 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 No!
No!
Hello, I'm Max today. I'm here with Conor Menon. and I'm here with Owen Butcher. Ahead of this match of the Hoggiers against the Rugby Boys this year, we've caught up with some interviews with Jack Malala.
Scott, you've been training a lot this year. How's pre-season going?
It's not been too bad, you know. A lot of hard sessions there out in the pitches, you know. I was practicing my crossbar challenges there in the pre-season game against Armagh. I feel I'm ready for this game. You know, hit the gym hard and we're ready.
How do you feel about Shane McLaughlin's people's captain status?
Well, as I've said many times before, the people's captain only has to check the captain's board to see that my name is up there, albeit spelled incorrectly, but it is there.
And what do you think about Shea being as in form as he is?
I think he's dropped in recent weeks, you know. I believe he has a big performance in him for the Leavers hockey match. He's been talking himself up for a few weeks, you know. He's got himself in the gym, he's got himself in good shape. I think he could play a key role in the game on Wednesday.
Thank you very much, Scott. So, Bordy, how's it feel marking the head girl, Claire Whiteside?
I think it'd be difficult, but she's got no height. Nicole Connor would be more difficult, to be honest, to be fair. But it's no problem to me.
That's a big statement. How do you reply to the rumours of your bad attitude problem?
I took Luke McNamara's spot in the sweeper role. Perfect.
What's your favourite type of mean?
Hey, and Brew, by mean.
Are you supplying at half time?
It's up to Stubby.
Right, thank you very much. How are you going to control the pace of Claire McCool?
It's quite simple. There's an easy plan at the back. Because Alex, Cramsey, myself, just going to keep a tight line, don't let her pass, and man mark her when we have to.
How did you feel about early in the season getting dropped from the first?
Well, took it hard at the time, we all know that. Gus came in, took one position, got injured, but here we are. They built my character, made me into the man I am today, back in the starting 11, and I'm going to prove myself. Definitely.
Okay, one final question. Big Al, big raider, yes or no?
Big hockey player, that's all you need to know.
Thank you very much. Shay, how do you think this hockey match is going to go?
Well, after the last few training sessions, I really feel the boys have a good chance here. We're going to win this big game. We're bringing home for the boys.
How red will your face actually get in this match?
Oh, well, if there was a skill, it'd be Shay red.
And what position are you playing in this match?
Centre forward, but throughout the game, with subs coming in, I might be moved to doggy.
Right, and last question, high ball, what's the secret?
There's no secret.
How's training going?
It's going really well. I've been training for about 5 hours a week for the past few weeks now.
How long have you been playing hockey now?
I've been playing hockey professionally since I was 5, and I've also represented Ulster on their hockey team.
Final question, how big is Bob's house?
It's quite big. It's a semi-converted loft house.
So Claire, can you reveal any tactics for the game?
Well, we've been working hard consistently now to the Stormtroopers. We have key players here at the back with loads of experience. And I think if we target down the middle, if we target these areas, we can achieve.
So Claire, how do you respond to the rumours of the love affair between you and the other team captain, Shane McLaughlin?
I can tell you now, they're untrue.
Was he a good Kurt?
No.
You picked up an injury just before the big game. Are you going to make an appearance?
Well, at the minute I don't quite know, but hopefully I'll know on the day.
So who do you think your Catholic influence will help the game?
Well, I mean, we're all naturals, but I'm going to get my granny to light a few candles for us and I'll say my prayer before the game and we'll be fine.
Thank you, Beth. Melanie, have you done much prep for the game?
Well, unlike the boys, we've been practicing all year, so hopefully that'll be in our favour.
So do you feel the girls can win the match then?
I know the girls will win the match, Jack.
Recently, the boys' captain, Shane McLaughlin, has been in form. I've heard that he has caught you up in his red-faced web. Any truth in this, Mel? I hear you like to keep fit. Do you think you can outrun Jordan North in the game?
Oh, definitely. He'll be way miles behind me.
Kayla's Wednesday after the match. Any thoughts?
Well, it should be good. Should be good.
On a scale of 1 to Shay's face, how Matthew Boyle are you?
I'd say about 7.52.
Thank you very much. So you think it'll be a big scoreline in the match?
Hopefully we'll have the lead by a long way.
How's the goal from?
Going like a bomb.
So was Ross a good Kurt? And is Jamie Gault coming to support?
He's too busy at tech.
Now we'll look at the bookies odds. And these are some of the odds heading into the game. Girls 3-7-1, boys 5-2 on Robert Williams betting.co.uk.
Better Robert way.
A special offer, straight from Robert Williams, .co.uk. Shady Paul Kelly's, 2-1. Inform, red face. Highball, mass.
Get your communion
in. What else? That's all for the day, folks.
We'll see you in mass.
Okay, turn round now, guys. Shake hands. Good luck.
Do you fancy?
I fancy the girls today, sort of, because, well, I'll just be looking a bit off them later on. But, you know, the main question is, Ben, would you like a beer? There we go. Crack her open there, son. So, really, we're just sitting down here, you know, watching the game. Thanks, Ben. And,
let's kick off. Who's referee?
Girls just kicked off there, so they did.
Oh, poor touch, McQuillan.
And the ball just was pretty good.
Go on, Jen!
Ben is going for the boys, as you can tell. You know, Ben likes a bit of the boys. And, kicking off the game here, so we'll catch back with you in about 5 minutes.
Well, but a controversial first goal for the girls, I think it was. Not sure who, somebody hit it outside the D. Had the keeper went in, so it's going down as a David Robb own goal.
It was a bit of a disgrace, to be honest. You know, the referee was very biased indeed and not very happy with
that. The girls are on the way with it. Claire Whiteside has been a bit of a Paul Scholes figure in midfield, just pulling the strings. Doing really well. I think Claire McCool had a good chance early on, but then the girls got a hank. I don't know what it's called in hockey, but it was like a corner kick.
Useless.
And topped the ball to Claire Whiteside. She just slid it into Jim Warnock and put it in the back of the net.
Aye, so Jim Warnock did that split second, and the boys are getting annihilated at the moment.
They're awful. I don't even think they've had one corner, and that's been it.
However, I am going to change sides, you know, up the boys and all the rest of that there. You know.
Mr. Rowe has been the most biased ref you will ever see.
Yes, I will.
I'd like to use stronger words than that, but.
We are on camera. So that's half time for you, 2-0 to the girls. Second half still to come, and look forward to joining you later on.
That I found myself a cheerleader. She is always right there when I need her. Oh, I think that I found myself a cheerleader. She is always right there when I need her. She walks like a model. She grants my wishes like a genie in a bottle. Yeah, 'cause I'm the wizard of told me.
Space.